We'll start with a small video.
Once upon a time, there was an organization called the World Bank, who had a group of friends called the corporations. The World Bank played a trick on the people of the world, saying that if everyone helped the corporations get richer, then the whole world would get richer. So the World Bankers started to pave the way for the corporations to take control of some of the world's most valuable resources, like land, water, and forests. They created a system called the Doing Business Rankings, which ranked all the countries in the world according to how easy it was for the corporations to do business there. To do well in the rankings, countries had to let the corporations buy up their land and resources, clear off all the smallholder farmers who were already there, and make sure the corporations had to pay very little tax. If the countries didn't do well in the rankings, then the World Bankers lent them less money and made sure they got less investment from rich countries. So thanks to the system, the corporations got rich, the rich got richer, and they all lived happily ever after.
Recently in the parliament, the commerce minister, then commerce minister, Nirmala Sitharaman made this statement. The statement was that India had done 7,000 small and big reforms. 7,000 small and big reforms for the ease of doing business. So this is stated in the parliament. In Davos, in the speech, Modi talked about 10,000 changes being made in various acts, policies of this country to adhere with the ease of doing business. So what is this ease of doing business? Who is promoting that? And what are the changes that is happening in the ease of doing business? The ease of doing index, as we see it, there was this huge celebration all around when the index of India moved from 134 to 100, which meant that India is high in the rank. We are moving closer to for business to perform better. And BJP and all the other forces celebrated the change in the ranking. Let's look into what happened in this ranking. And before that, let me talk about what is this ease of doing business. The ease of doing business is an index which comes as part of the ease of doing business report, which World Bank and the International Finance Corporation, the private arm of the World Bank, they bring this report together. I mean, this is basically meant to promote the IFC interest, the private business interest, and has nothing to do with what World Bank has been saying in terms of poverty alleviation, and the kind of social structure, so sector processes which the World Bank have been saying up to now. I mean, whether they are doing it or not, there's another question. This has nothing to do with it. This is basically ease of doing private business. And the major understanding of this report is that regulations are bad. And if you have lesser regulations, and that lesser regulations will create a better business environment, will percolate. And from 2004, when the business report started, they said the same single set of indicators could be used across the countries, 190 countries. That time it was 133. It started with 69, I think. So the same indicators could be used to measure business environment and business climate across. There have been huge questions which have been raised from within the bank and also outside the bank. It started with 5 indicators. Currently, we have about 11 indicators. And in the 11 indicators, one indicator, which was highly questioned by the trade unions, are now not part of the ranking, which is the employee workers indicator, EWI. So apart from that, the labor index, All the indexes are part of the ranking. It started with 5 indicators and moved on to about 10 indicators, and of the 10 indicators, 7 indicators are pushing for reduction of regulation. So it has a clear private bias which is inbuilt into this report. On a small scale, if we look into what are the 7,000 changes which has happened, what essentially this is that it has to make business easy to enter, work and exit business. So in all the three elements, the business, to enter into the business, for doing business and exiting from the business, all these things are being covered under the ease of doing business. One major change which has happened is easing the FDI norms, where many of our people have been fighting against reduction of the FDI norms, allowing higher FDI. Now even in terms of defense, they have allowed in the FDI, Anil Ambani getting this huge contract, the single retail which the hawkers have been fighting on entry of the FDI into the country. The statement that when Indian ranking moved from in the earlier position, not now that the 30 rank, 30 jumping is, before that they have jumped some 10 positions, about 40% of more FDI had come in. So the whole element of this doing business is to create that atmosphere in which the foreign direct investment will come in a huge way into this country. What all have changed in otherwise with this report? They have done away with the site inspection for prospective projects in the forest land. So you don't, the number of regulations on each level has been reduced to such an extent that it has been giving a clear free way for the business to operate. So there is the requirement of compensatory afforestation, Forest Rights Act have been taken away from the prospective projects. The environment clearance validity has been increased from 5 to 7. The regional empowered committees at subnational level have been delegated the higher powers to dispose of proposals for forest clearance. So there need not be any forest clearance for involving diversion from 5 to 40 hectares of forest land. All proposals involving diversion of forest land for linear projects, irrespective of the forest land involved, now it has gone to the subnational level. So these, whatever kind of changes we are seeing, is directly linked to India's positioning in terms of the ease of doing business. If we also look into labor, we have about 45 labor laws, and of the 45 labor laws, they want to codify the labor laws into 4 labor codes. The huge reduction of any kind of regulation in the labor market. That's what ease of doing business is trying to bring about with these 4 codes. They brought about self-certification. So there is the amount of inspection in the name of reduction of inspection raj, as they call it. They have given the whole right of the business itself to self-regulate. So there is no regulation. We have to self certify whether they have been part of be adhering to labor laws, they have been adhering to environmental laws, etc., etc. And now we have started seeing what is happening regarding that. Whether it is the Kamala Bills fire, which happened in Bombay, the factory fire, or the Unjahar tragedy, the NTPC, because the boilers, they are putting in self inspection into the whole framework, or they have been deaths which I would have seen the statement by NTUI very recently attacking the ease of doing business we were directly responsible for labor deaths because it is bringing down the labor security out there. The startups have been exempted from inspection from labor laws in the first year. And the second year onwards, till third year, they have self-certification. And there will be no inspection until a credible and verifiable complaint of violation is filed. It's clearly opening up our business. There need not be any labor sector regulation, particularly with on safety measures. So this is what the code is trying to do. It's very interesting if you look into what had happened in Rajasthan. In Rajasthan, they had the amendments in the labor laws, the Industrial Dispute Act. So the threshold to form a unions have been highly increased. Earlier, it was 15% of the workforce was needed. Now they need 30%. Of the workforce to register a union. It allows for retrenching, laying off of units if they employ less than 300 workers. Earlier it was 100 workers. Now that has been increased. The definition of the factory itself has been changed. So many of the small units employing less than 40 need not come into the factory act at all. So these changes have been happening globally. Earlier in the beginning, they had the employing workers index in the ease of doing business. In the employing workers index, which have been highly contested by the trade unions, because what they look into is the ease of hiring and firing workers. So this doesn't go any way related to the ILO conventions, and ILO had opposed it. There have been any independent evaluation based on the critiques with the International Trade Union Confederation has done, and they have done away with the employment of the workers index from the ranking. But they still continue to do the ranking. But it's not just part of the so you will find an index down with the employment workers index, though the independent panel has clearly said after the discussion to take away this whole framework. What else is changing? Labor laws are changing, the environmental laws are changing, the Company Act had been changed, the stamp duties have been reduced, the recent reduction in this budget of the corporate tax from 30% to 25%, this is something which we had committed to the World Bank earlier itself. That is part of trying to get a better deal in the ease of doing business. Modi believes that we have to come into the first 50. Now we are from 142, we have to come to the first 50. And that is the movement in which all these reductions and regulations are being changed. Construction sector, particularly with the urban areas, many to start a unit, so many of the regulations have been done away with. They have the procedure is, which earlier used to have 42 procedures, now it's just 8. Single window clearance. So if you there is an automatic, if you don't get an answer within a time period, it is deemed as given. The construction permit has been deemed as given. The time limits have been set. And those time limits are really small window time limits in which all the inspections have to happen. And if they don't happen, it is as good as they're getting in. So in the urban sector also, in terms of construction, in terms of we all know the huge the builder lobby and what they do. So they are getting it very easy now. In the whole thing. Meanwhile, one of those provisions had been challenged in the NGT and was stuck down in the name of housing for the poor. So the environmental laws, they did not comply with the environmental laws of more than 15,000 square feet. I mean, where in the urban poor you have 15,000 square feet of construction happening. So, I mean, but that was shut down, luckily, by the LDT. Let's also look about the recent, again, controversies, whether it's the insolvency code, the FRDI bill. These are all coming from the whole concept of exiting business and how it is making easy for the business business to exit. So, when the when we introduce the insolvency code, when we have the surface, the ranking went up. So what we fight against have a direct relation being pushed from this report. It's the same thing with the GST. It's related with the paying tax indicator. So what? So generally, this is what is being pushed in the ease of doing business. Have it been challenged? Yes, it has been challenged globally. Both India in the beginning had challenged the ease of doing business and its indicators. They clearly said it is not robust at all. Then the Indian Aravind Subramaniam at that point of time had written that ease of doing business had been shut down. But that was in the UPA era. UPA was also in the last framework trying to be in the better books of the World Bank. But from there, from the period when the present government came in, we can see a huge shift in the Indian position of questioning the ease of doing business and questioning its indicators. For example, in the paying tax indicator, one company sources all the information from 142 countries. So where do they gather the data? Where that is the PricewaterhouseCoopers. So the PricewaterhouseCoopers is the only company which collects data on the taxes and reports it to the ease of doing business. And they have been the single source for this report. This has been questioned by the independent panel set up by the World Bank itself. How can you source your indicators from this narrow base, from a single company to get the information about an indicator? They have been the independent panel actually has said that very many changes have to be. They said there is a clear-cut bias. The World Bank legal unit publicly said that there is an embedded policy preference under the indicators favoring business. This is not something which is coming out just from the civil society. I'm trying to say what has come from within the bank itself. From within the bank, the legal unit had questioned it. Within the bank, the independent panel which has been set up, they had questioned this whole idea that regulation is bad. And reduction of regulation is what is good for the business. This is a very myopic, narrow view of understanding business, and that has been challenged also within the bank. It is the independent panel which flagged that the 7 of the 10 indicators presume that the lessening of regulation is always desirable. So this is again what is coming from the from the bank. There has been an independent panel which have been constituted. Actually, the independent panel had been constituted when India and China, as I said earlier, questioned the indicators, in which Arun Mehra, at that point of time, who was the Planning Commission member, was part of the independent panel, and they said the World Bank should do away with the ranking. They said, let the report be there. You can't just place one country over the other and assume that someone in a bigger rank has a better business climate. And the whole assumptions have been done away with. So this is a clear regulation, which is clear suggestions which have come from the independent panel itself. Very recently, last year when India jumped the from 133 to 100, the 100, at the same time, Chile had also faced the same problem. The chief economist of the World Bank, many of you know, you have been learning about him. He had been kicked out from the World Bank, to use it in the same way, because he challenged the indicators. In Chile, it has been clearly mentioned that there have been an interference. When there's a socialist government in Chile, the indicators went down, which means business doesn't invest into the country. So as we see, the IFI, the role, particularly the World Bank role of being a gatekeeper of the global finance, globally, because of the ease of doing business, private firms, equities, and every investment is being decided based on whether they are up in the rank or low in the rank. And that is why there's a huge jump in the FDI which happened once our rank went up. So it has the potential to destroy a nation, to destroy and also to decide on the ranking. In case of India, there have been a group who have been looking into this thing, looking into the indicators, and they came out with a report which said India's reduction in the rank or India's jumping into the rank was not because of India's scored better. It is just because the indicators have changed every year. So if we see 2004 to 2017, every year there have been one or the other change in terms of the indicators. New indicators have been added. So it is not comparable. So India's business environment, even if you take into all the measurements using the fixed index, what they did was that they used the same index of 2014 to see what is the shift in 2017. And they found that the Indian jump was very negligible. The whole idea being, this report is now an instrument in the hands of the international financial institutions to regulate financing to the countries and make policy changes as they wish in every country. So it's Joe differs with me, but some of us still call it the new SAP. It's a new SAP in which conditionalities have been put in a different way, in which people adhere, our policies are being attuned to a particular way in which the business is being, private business is being favored. We would be coming out with a small booklet on many of these things, trying to see what have been the major critics, what have been, what did independent panel say, what did the trade union response where there have been protests from civil society groups, there have been campaigns. The video which I showed was from the Auckland Institute's website. So there have been the Bretton Woods project have been fighting it. So there have been globally, people have also been fighting this, apart from locally people questioning the ranks as India and the China did. A lot many other countries have also joined the bandwagon, challenging the ranking system.
First and foremost, if I'm not mistaken, it's New Zealand now, not Singapore, which tops the list. Well, okay. Second thing is, when you talk about ease of doing business, the criticism needs to start with, it's not the whole country that we are talking about as far as ease of doing business is concerned. In India, it's just the two cities where you have the survey conducted, Delhi and Bombay. So based on these two sample cities, the World Bank's ease of doing business can never really paint a larger picture of the economic growth of the country. That also gets me to a point that Ulkatai had made about the MMRDA, and the IFS are seeing Mumbai as one of the most amazing locations to invest in. Now, this is kind of conjoined with the ease of doing business of World Bank, and Mumbai scores over Delhi only by the fact of it having a amazing natural harbor. So ease of doing business is basically not about these 11 indicators. I remember having one of these discussions with Joe also, there are indices, there are sub-indices which calculate what exactly is the EODB. For instance, yeah, but the most important fact, I think, which somehow you must have, because of time, missed out on was, our ranking has improved precisely because of what has come in courtesy the Modi government as protection of the investor, and how the investors can now with ease get registered with SEBI. So FRDI or the bankruptcy filing or the insolvency filing are just mere branches out of this. So in short, if you want to criticize ease of doing business, one way is to say is like, as Leo just showed in his 12 charts, you cannot compare the rich with the poor on economic indicators alone. That itself is a very faulty position to start off with. Secondly, ease of doing business has not improved the real economy. It will never improve the real economy, and that's the major criticism coming from within the World Bank and the IMF. There's a likelihood that this report might even be scrapped in future.
It's only two cities which they measure. But what has happened is that the state itself has taken over this. They have committed with a 98-point plan in which what has to change. They also have a subnational report. India had a subnational report earlier. And now within the country, they have, it is not limited to Bombay or Delhi. So they have a state index now. And they have business reform action plans, starting with the 98-point action plan, which moved the regulations in a high scale. Now we have something like 405 business action reform plans, of which the about excluding some 5 or 6 states, 95 and above is what states are adhering to the changes in plan. So that is there in the Indian Commerce Ministry site, the DIPB site. All the state governments, not just Bombay and Delhi, have more than 90% adherence to some of those big changes which is happening. So we should not just be looking at Bombay, Delhi, it's pan India. Because the state wants it pan-India.
Added to demystifying the ease of doing business, supplementing the points that Soumya and Leo made, there's a lot of research that, you know, shows what has been the impact of diluting FDI norms in terms of adding to manufacturing capacity in India, linked to the point Leo made, what kind of jobs have been created. Has there been transfer of technology to domestic firms? What kind of jobs have been sort of displaced, maybe in the retail sector, in many other sectors due to, you know, the increasing mechanization? So it could be looking at the automotive sector where, you know, you have had a lot of adherence to this ease of doing business framework. And there's a recent study that came out of IISD, the Indian Institute for Studies in Industrial Development in Delhi, by two professors called Chalapati Rao and Biswajit Dar, where they've completely debunked this make in India of the last 3 years. Adding to debunking this, you should also bring in real case studies, and like Leo said, look at some specific sectors where you actually show that there are no decent jobs, it's sort of contractual, bad paid jobs in many sectors. I mean, that's how you can connect it to more people.
There was a standing committee which looked into the ease of doing business. And one interesting thing the standing committee did, they have the business action plan where they have land enablers. And there they said the Gujarat model of the Land Acquisition Act, where they have watered down the National Acquisition Act, which is a watered down of what the movements were asking, that is going to be the model for the rest of the country. And when we look into this parliamentary committee report, actually it's a cut paste from an Accenture report, which has been done by the DIPB with the department. So this is where it is changing, the land acquisition, and what is being pushed is not just these indicators, which I agree with you. They are pushing a huge lot of liberal measures under this guise.